All right, cool, ready to go? Yeah, awesome. So, hey.
Oh, sorry.
All right, so. Okay, sorry, guys. You see what happens when you make personalized calendars and send it out to the family? It becomes a thing. And if you're up for the role of chief calendar maker, stay tuned and I'll show you how easy it is to create one-of-a-kind gifts like this one. Hi, I'm Rachael from Canva Design School, and in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to design and print your own personalized calendar. We'll cover how to piece together a calendar featuring your fave family photos, as well as how to create theme designs, like these ones, using templates. I'll even show you how to share your designs with colleagues to collaborate on the ultimate work calendar. We're releasing videos weekly, so before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button. All right, let's check out some templates so we can start inspired. I'll head to Canva's homepage and type in calendars. Look at all of these options. Hover your cursor over the top to see if it has additional pages. Some designs will include an entire year, while others may feature 1 month. Oh, and see this crown symbol? This means it's only for a Pro or Canva for Teams user, but the rest are totally free for anyone to use. For this first calendar, since it's for the family, I want it to be colourful and quirky, like us. And as you saw, there'll be lots of photos, so I need to make sure there's enough room. Perhaps I'll add the word picture to the search. Ah, that's better. Something simple I can easily customize. First, change the background color by heading over here. Then a contrasting color for the lines and text. And to add my own photos, I'll need to upload them first. So I can do that by clicking here or by dropping them straight into the editor. For the front page, I'll add a photo of our family home, so I'm not accused of playing favourites. Just drag and drop it into the existing image. And to crop it, I'll hit this button. That's sweet. Now for a quote that'll melt their hearts. That's sure to get some brownie points with Mum. All right, front cover is done. Time to work on the month of January. Speaking of Mum, she loves the beach, so I'll include that to really kick the year off right. Next, I'll change the background color to something more vibrant. A nice pop of color will get her tick of approval. This page looks a little bland, so perhaps I'll add in some text to set the scene. And maybe a graphic. I'll just search in the Elements tab. Yep. This is perfect. And on the other side of this spread, let's not forget family birthdays. I'll just copy and paste this type and change the text and the color. Maybe make it a bit bigger and let's add some arrows pointing to it. Well, I am doing all the work here, so I don't want them to forget and being so close to Christmas. For February, I'll feature my brother's dog. Since I've got a couple of great photos I'd like to include, I'll delete this frame and add a grid instead. I'll search grid in the Elements tab and look for a layout that suits the orientation of my photos. This should work well. I'll resize it first. Then drop the photos in one at a time. Once again, I'll use the crop tool and reposition the photos within the frame. That looks great. I'll add a little graphic here. Now for the background color. See how easy it is? Once you've done a couple of the pages, the rest will become second nature. There's just one more feature I want to show you before we move on to printing. Say you've received a photo from Grandma, but the lighting isn't quite right. You can make photo adjustments by clicking over here. Use the sliders to adjust the brightness and contrast, or select from the variety of filters. That looks better. Add in special dates. On this one, I'll add duotone to create an artistic effect. Select it, hit Edit Image, and choose Duotone. Simply tap one of the swatches, then click again to select different colors and play around with the intensity. As you can see, there are lots of different ways to spice up your photos. Just make sure you don't go too overboard, otherwise your calendar could appear too chaotic or inconsistent. A good rule of thumb is to incorporate no more than 3 fonts and decide on a color palette instead of choosing at random. Once you've reached the final page, you may want to get the family's approval before printing. To create a view only link, head up to share and click here. This is what they will see. They can leave reactions but not affect the design. If you are happy to give them more creative control, you can add them in here. And they can jump in and start designing. And once everyone's happy, or close to, hit this button and review the front and back cover before continuing. Oh, and don't forget to select the quantity. I'm going to need at least 10 for my family. Per calendar, it's pretty cheap when you think they're going to be using this all year round. When you hit continue, Canva will do a quick press check to make sure there'll be no issues at the printer. And in no time, they'll be turning up on your doorstep. Oh. Wow, how good does this look? Now, next up, we're going to talk themed calendars. So this could be anything from fluffy felines to ramen restaurants. Whatever your thing, you can probably find it in Canva's photo library, meaning you don't even need your own shots to get started. For example, check out this calendar I made for my friend who's planning a holiday traveling by motorbike. These images were easy to find in the Elements tab. Just type in what you were looking for, and drag and drop it into a frame. Done! And the same goes for this yearly calendar I made for a vintage car mechanic. After finding the perfect picture, I added a logo along with the business contact details. This could be a promo or mailed out to loyal customers as a thank you. Before we go any further, I would love to hear what theme or style of calendar you plan on making. Let me know in the comments whether you'd like to feature your family, favourite animals, food, or something else. Alrighty, I have one more calendar to show you, one for your work colleagues. First, select a template and customise it for the business by adding your logos and brand colours. I'm using the brand kit here. Brand kits make it super easy to customize something for your business in next to no time. Invite everyone to join by adding their email addresses here. Or create a shareable link like this. Once they're in, you can work on pages together or assign everyone a page to complete independently. They can leave comments for you and you can answer in the thread using stickers or even assign things to specific people. And another hot tip, use this button whenever you see a graphic you like. That way you can add more like it or even discover others you'd prefer. And if a fellow designer needs to know where to find an element, they can hit this icon to get all the info they need and more. You can even see more like this here. Pretty handy, huh? Well, I hope you're feeling fired up and ready to create your own unique calendar. What questions do you have for me? Let me know in the comments. Did you find this video helpful? If the answer's yes, could you do me a small favor and make sure you like it? This would really help others to see it too. We release new videos weekly, so subscribe if you don't want to miss out. In fact, you could check out some of them now. Here's the playlist and one of my favorites. I hope you enjoy them. Thanks for watching.